Stay tuned for the third update on the awesome new DMC bucket seat. Hi guys, thanks for tuning in again today, and I'm really awesomely excited today to show you some first photos of our new DMC bucket seats. If you remember, we already showed you two videos before, and among the first videos there was this seat that we did. We designed the complete seat in the computer. We're probably going to show you some photos here. After we designed the seat in the computer, it was time to make a prototype. This prototype was actually made from foam. You can, I'm gonna blend the link in here so you can see the old video as well. Why did we make the first prototype from foam? Well, that's very easy. Even though we are quite confident about the design that we made in the computer, but you never know whether it really fits or not. So imagine if you would open a mold, you make a tooling for the seats or for any product you were about to design without test fitting it, and then it doesn't fit eventually. That would be really bad. So one of the easiest things to do is to either 3D print something, or in this case, it's actually CNC from a big block of styrofoam. That was the first video, and we gave you some update video a few months later. And today is probably the last video before we're gonna show you the final product. And I'm very happy to show you two photos. Now, I'll go a bit to the side, and then we're gonna blend in the photo of the first product here. And just look at this. Isn't that beautiful? This is basically the seat as it comes fresh out of the mold. In fact, this is the first test shot we did. We don't really call it test shot. Shot, you usually refer to something which is plastic injected. This is pure pre-packed carbon fiber. You can see at the side of the seat, there are still some raw carbon fibers, literally fibers. Looking out. Now, what's that all about? Let me give you some background info in case you don't know. When you put the carbon fiber into the mold, it's never really exact to the shape, because fibers are similar fibers like my t-shirt, and whether you take pre-packed carbon or visible carbon. So, and when you put the fibers into the mold, you basically have to cut them off, and they're just there, okay? So this is what you see here in the photo. The next step would be then to trim those fibers off, and to make the edge smooth, and then connect the back of the seat to the front of the seat. So if you're ready, here's the next photo. Look at this. Oh my God, awesome. So here you can see already, we have totally eliminated all these fibers that you saw. This is absolutely a natural phenomenon when you produce carbon fiber. And the backside and the front side have already merged together. And I think the seat just looks phenomenal, astonishing, amazing. You shouldn't talk too much. You shouldn't, in Germany we say, you shouldn't talk too much about how good yourself are. And actually, that's not what I'm doing here. I want to praise our whole team in Germany for making an awesome seat like this. I think it just looks totally awesome. So even though the seat looks quite finished here, it is not quite yet finished. The next step would now be a polishing, and then there would be an appliance of clear coat as well, either glossy or matte. And of course, if you remember that this seat has been inspired by us, we took the inspiration from the McLaren Senna seats. So one of the most important points still missing is the leathers, the paddings, the cushions, which are going to add on here. Let me show you some photo how we imagine this to look later. You can either do it like this. This looks pretty nice with these individual cushions in that color, or like that. That looks nice as well. Or if you prefer, we can also do a complete full cover. Now actually one of the things we mentioned in the second video was that this is already our second size that we're doing. This prototype was our first size. This was for the Porsche 993, and then we developed a second smaller size. Yes, the Porsche 993 seats are actually quite wide. We developed a new size which fits the Aventador. Yes, I know, Aventador sounds like you're gonna use a really big white seat. Actually not. BMW M2, so this is the second seat. And actually the one that I just showed you in the photo, this is the second size already. You can see it's a little bit more narrow than the first iteration we did. But in fact, a lot of people have asked us to make it more accessible so that we can have the seat in use in some other cars, like, as I just said, in some compact super sport cars, in German exotics like the BMW M2, C63S, why not? All right, so I hope this is it today for this video. I hope in the next video I'll be able to show you the final product. We might do one more in-between update about this seat, because a lot of you guys are really contacting us and asking us for updates. We really love your enthusiasm. Please keep the messages coming. If you have any questions, let us know. Either leave comments down below this video or drop us a direct message. We hope you liked this video. If you did like this video, please give us a thumbs up or click that like button depending on the platform where you're watching this. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so yet, and hit that little bell icon. Only then you get notifications when we upload new videos. And we're going to show you next to me now how you're going to do this in some other channels as well. Depending on the platform, as I mentioned before, where you're watching this, is a little bit different if you want to turn on notifications, but that helps you and helps us as well. Please help us to get some likes. Can we get 100 likes on this video? That would be really awesome. Likes are free, so please keep the likes coming. You can really help us with this. Let me say thank you one more time for watching, and I'll see you next time with more DMC content. Until then, DMC life. Now, after that, I also gave you another update video, but today I'm finally so happy to show you a first photo, actually two photos of the prototype. Yes, it's not gonna be more than that. All right, the air condition is a little bit windy. Let me put this to the side. Okay, need to do it one more time, I think. I'll turn off the air condition. This might be too loud.
It's okay, it's funny.
Yeah?
You can't auch funny thing now.
Okay. But I turn it off anyway.